Good morning, everyone. Today is June 22, 2020. You know, when I was a little kid, grade 4 student in Don Bosco, Tarlac, one of the things that I looked forward to was to receiving the Salesian Bulletin. It is the journal or the magazine of the Salesian family in the Philippines. Later on, I came to know that it was founded by Don Bosco himself, and that it has been published in many different countries. And of course, they have different topics according to the locality. However, one thing that is very interesting is that there's one message by the Rector Major for all these issues of the Salesian Bulletin, or for all these different versions of the Salesian Bulletin in different languages. And he delivers it every month. And even today, we would see the message on the website of the Salesians. For this year, we have in June 2020, a message about young people. By the way, this magazine, the Salesian Bulletin, is available to us here in the Philippines under the name St. John Bosco Today. Once upon a time, it was a Salesian Bulletin. But I think in order to make Don Bosco more alive, for others to see that it is really about Don Bosco's creation in his own time, this publication of the magazine, then we have shifted to St. John Bosco Today. But ultimately, it's a Salesian Bulletin around the world. And for the message of the Rector Major, who is the successor of Don Bosco, for June 2020, he spoke about this question: what would we do without the young in our lives? And I'd like to quote some parts that would seem pertinent for this good morning talk. And I quote, "The young people told us that they love us, that they really love us as educators, and like friends, brothers, and parents. Since," they added, "the young people of today suffer from a great dearth of fatherly care and concern. I have always thought to myself, and now I repeat it to myself after the close of our recent General Chapter 28 in Valdoco, Turin, in the very places where our father Don Bosco lived with his voice, that young people are our raison d'être, that is, reason of being. Just as was the case with Don Bosco, the young make us better, helping us expand our hearts, making us more generous, and leading us to regard life with hope and with a smile on our face." Before I move on, I was very fortunate to be part of this 28th General Chapter that was held in Turin. The top gathering of the Salesians around the world, where every province is represented, and the Salesian Philippine province of the north, together with Malaysia, of course, it's one of the 94 provinces or 95 provinces in the chapter. And of course, included also is Philippines South. And here, our experience in the General Chapter is really something great and tremendous, because we had important acts to do, like, for example, the legislative agenda, where we would be revising part of the Constitution. And another one is to have a reflection. Where are we going as Salesians? The question is, what kind of Salesians do we need for the young people of today? And what is special about this is that in that chapter, in the 28th General Chapter, we had the presence of young people. Not everybody could come, but there were about 16 who were able to make it to join the capitulars or the Salesians as observers and guests. And two of them came from the Philippines. One from the north, Mr. Andre Launo, and the other one from the south, Zenaida Ann Taichi Miranda. And they joined the young people from all over the world, from East Asia, Oceania, from Africa, from Europe, from Latin America, from the Americas, and other regions, other provinces. I'd like to continue with what the Rector Major was saying. he was, I quote once again, "I truly believe that this is so. If there should be a Salesian educator, whether consecrated or lay, who does not feel this, then he or she is simply someone who is a mere worker, earning a living in the field of education, but not living, quote-unquote, art of education with a passion." And as I said, no, here he, the rector major says these words, "There were 16 young people from 5 continents who accompanied us on our journey at the general chapter. These young adults were between the ages of 25 and 30. As soon as they arrived, they connected with each other and with us in a wonderful manner. Indeed, let me share with you what they told us and asked of us. We have succeeded," and I quote, "we have succeeded in having our hearts beat in unison. You have given us the opportunity to connect with you, Salesians, whom we want to be among us. You did this in your Salesian style. Stay with us, side by side, and allow us to be protagonists too. Both they and we come to understand a number of things. One of them, which was very interesting to me, was this. The young people told us that it was difficult for them to understand each other, not only due to the diversity of languages, since not everyone knew English, it could not be used as a bridge, but also because they found it very difficult to understand one another's concepts, mentalities, customs, and values. And they were all young adults in the group. There was no generation gap among them. The young people told us that they love us, that they really love us as educators and like friends, brothers, and parents, since they added the young people of today suffer from a great dearth of fatherly care and concern. They asked us to be their companions on the road. They told us they don't need us to tell them what to do and what not to do. They don't want us to make things easy for them. What they don't need is for us to tell them how they have to think and live. But they do want us by their side, even when they make mistakes. They asked us to accompany them along the path of life and to stay close to them as well, while they go through the steps of making important decisions. I was moved to hear them say, with tears in their eyes, that they needed us to show them that God loves them, that there is a God who is love and who loves them unconditionally, and that someone needs to keep repeating this over and over again to every young person in this world today. We were left speechless. Yet again, the young people evangelized us. It was one of my predecessors, the Rector Major Don Juan Edmundo Vecchi, who once wrote that young people save us. So it is. The young save us from getting into a rut and from the kind of fatigue that no amount of sleep can fix. They save us from becoming comfortable, from living a life without hope and without faith. They ultimately save us from being mediocre people. And the Rector Major concludes his message, "Dear young people, we Salesians of today's world tell you that we love you, that our life is for you, and that just as it was for Don Bosco, for you I study, for you I work, for you I live, and for you I am even willing to give my very life. I wish you every happiness in the Lord." And this is from Father Angel Fernandez Artime, the 10th successor of Don Bosco, the Rector Major of the Salesians of Don Bosco. And there you find in the picture, in the center, during the 28th General Chapter, or GC28, the Rector Major flanked by the young people who came to GC28. You know, my dear friends, I reflected upon this because this term, or trimester, I will be teaching our college students St. John Bosco and the Preventive System. The course number is DB 100. And one of the things that we would be asking is, what are the needs and challenges of today's youth? What do they need? And what is the profile of the youth today? And of course, the response that we have, Don Bosco, the Salesian family, the preventive system. And this is a great jumping board for this topic, what we have just read today. What would we do without young people in our lives? Because if there aren't any young people, I would not be here as a Salesian. Don Bosco would not find that meaning that he found in his life had there been no young people. And our congregation would not be anymore be relevant if there will be no more young people in the world. So we pray for this, that the young people may continue to be guided, that the young people, now even in this what we call a new situation that we have in our lives, that they be guided by Salesians. And this is the challenge for all of us. How do we continue guiding them? My dear friends, please do pray for young people. I would like to greet you all. Have a good day. God bless you.